command or chief engineer or something similar. Okay, that's hurt. That hurt. But hey, Innovators Online, so that's good. Ooh, Angelo versus Banagher again. I'll just use Flicker. Zero wins just in case anyone else attacks me who I can retaliate against. Banagher Lynx, your existence has caused the commander to question himself. That's where you're wrong. He's only returned to his true self. Commander B. By the commander, I presume he means Full Frontal. Full Frontal is not here. You have to walk your own path to find yourself. Think you know everything? You took the commander away from me! I'll never let you live that down. Angelo, you're... I think Yataran and Keiyuki were introduced for Harlock's own series. Throw in? No, I don't. Don't use Persist, because I'm kind of squishy. I don't want to get blowed up. Ah, you missed. Good. But don't persist. Luna Maria is definitely beginning some XP this mission, I think. Yep, another 3 levels. Nice. All right, I want to keep some. Oh, I'm in bad health shape. Active. Okay. Interesting. Their hit chance went up as my hit points went down. Went up as well. Okay. Right. You, I need to. Live because I need to have to be there for a map attack. But that persists if you tag me, so that's good. Kill you. I Okay, that's not good. Evade, 45% enhanced, level persist, active. Okay. All stars is good. Right, you I can tag. Ah, crossbow, enemy crossbow inside to move into action. But ready to take action. I just love the whole thing of like mecha punching capital shit. For extra damage. It's an amusing visual. Okay, this could okay. Your chance of hitting me is really low, so that's good. I'm really glad I activated zero in. It started the turn. Otherwise, it could have gone really bad. Double up! Special dialogue here? Not much in terms of special dialogue. That's kind of a bummer. In light of something specific to Hey, the fact that he's fighting a bio brain clone based off his alternate universe psychoframe data. So the characters who tend to take place of Totoro get either Keiyuki or Yataran. Yataran's the guy with the bandana and the glasses. Who's always working on plastic model kits. So, fun fact about Yataran. He is based off a real person who Leiji Matsumoto knows and was assistant on his work. The guy who did that is also the creator of Area 80... Yataran is based on is the creator of Area 88. His name just slipped my head right now, but basically what he would do is when Leiji Matsumoto was working on Yamato and Galaxy Express 3-9 and various other stuff, he'd do model kits as reference for the art. And so he would make assistant in that way. But he'd also had the trait that Yataran has of, hey, he's working on the model kit, don't bother him. He's going to put everything else aside while he's putting together his model. So it's kind of very much a very straightforward XP of the care of the real person. That was interesting. The thing I'm bummed about here is... I'm glad that Tobia and Kincaid both have special dialogue for these fights. Oh, I really bad at Iron Wall running there. But Amuro doesn't. And he really should. We only got three. No SR point this time. Like, the problem with these SR points for, hey, take out this many guys with a map attack. Wow! Everything missed. You're basically putting the success on the SR point on RNG. Use that. Bullseye. That was a mistake. But yeah. I haven't seen that far in Galaxy Express 3.9. For the arcade unit to do, so I kind of put it on hold about 16, 17 episodes in. It's a very episodic show, and I was watching it in binge. And binge watching Galaxy Express 3.9 is not the way to watch that show. It is definitely a show meant to be watched in an episodic manner. It had that in mind. Yes, there are some multi-part stories, and those kind of work to watch together in one chunk, but it's not like... It's very much like Star Trek in that regard. I got the NTD. And Seed? So yeah, I need to finish Galaxy Express 3.9. Levels. Now you have a capital ship to start shooting at. I am using Reservate. I am using cut the demo sequences for Yamato sparingly, because I noticed the Yamato footage is more likely to get me flagged. Maybe. Most series, the Yamato doesn't take a lot of damage to combat. Noticed. The assist animation for this. I don't think I've seen Banagher's assist dialogue. Assuming I don't just off him in the first attack, which happens a lot with the Fang deck. Yeah. Even with like the regular damage or the non-crit stuff. Like the Fang decks, as I mentioned when we got it. it's basically got the same design principle as Defiant from Star Trek Deep Space Nine. It is a bunch of guns strapped on some engine. Aha! I can hit you, Zabine! What does expert be? I haven't played T yet, but if I was going to write him in the game... I'd lean forward. I haven't played T yet, but if I was going to design him in the game... I haven't played T, so I'm not familiar with the expert system. How it articulates exactly, honest. But his shtick is very much mechanical stuff. I mean, he's a good gunner and that sort of thing. But he's also, like, really heavily into, mechanical aspect of the ship. Excuse me, I'm ham now. How many times have we met in battle now, Kincaid? I'm not sure, but I do know that this time will be our last. Oh? I see you're ready for a fight. Which one of us do you think will truly die today? I'm here today to end this little rivalry we have between us, Kincaid. Change, Sabine. I think there was a time when we fought side by side to protect Barra together. That's why it is my duty to finally end this. As a member of the Crossbone Vanguard, I have to put an end to your aristocratism once and for all. It is her wish, and I will fulfill it. Nice crit.
Yarina, Jinkedu. Sore de koso da. Jinkedu.
It's good to know the voice acting performance here that my level of ham is exactly the correct amount for this role. In response, but yeah, he's a little more gunner than Totoro. He is with Gatoran. Alright, keep working this flank. No. Don't go after that one. There we go! Alright. Oh, but I think Mara is gonna finish him off. That'll work. It'll work, okay. Then we can finally get to see Twee do an assist for dialogue from Iridia. Or I don't get the assist dialogue because I crit and one hit KO. That works too. In the arcade... Again, I haven't seen SSX, so I don't know how much they change of it from the movie, but in the Arcadia of My Youth movie, which leads into SSX, the start of the movie is the Death Shadow going down. It is Harlock intentionally scuttling Death Shadow so that it does not fall into the hands of the aliens occupying Earth. I can meal on assist, but I'm not gonna need it. Not for this guy. Though Harlock hasn't actually met Totoro by the time the Death Shadow goes down in SSX. Japan, RPG of my youth. Oh, I am gonna need the incense. Okay. As far as Harlock 78, they don't get into it too much. It's just that Harlock's Tochiro would just been building the Arcadia as an upgrade. Two levels for Riddy. Take down the High Mega Cannon. I think they both meet in prison. Harlock is arrested, drummed out of the service. So he's kind of going to get drummed out anyway. Gets into a bar fight, which is where he loses his eye. And after that's when he meets Tochiro. And then we get a psychic scan of the two of them, which shows that they are bonded through the ages. Their blood families have been bonded through the ages. And they use this to do a quick adaptation of two stories from another Leiji Matsumoto manga called The Cockpit. It's an ongoing series about planes and piloting. And the premise of that show is, it's one related to pilot trying to fly over the Andes running into Andes mountain range, South America, and running into a type of wind known as Stanley Witch, which ends up tying into the film's plot in a really weird way. And then the other one is another of Harlock's ancestors, who's a pilot in the Luftwaffe, deciding that he's had enough of the war and fuck the Nazis. We're gonna steal a bomb site, a German bomb site. Kim and Tochiro's ancestor are going to steal a German bomb site that Tochiro's ancestor had designed, based on a real German bomb site, by the way, and head to Switzerland to defect. I don't recall. I don't recall the answer to that question. It's actually been a few years since I've seen Arcadia of my youth. I'm tending to upgrade to the Discotech Media Blu-ray because Discotech Media is awesome. And they're doing the Lord's work when it comes to basically giving old anime Criterion Collection quality releases. And I'm all for that. Angry Fly. Fine. Here's a move position here. I'll resupply somebody anyway, just for XP. Let's level up. That works. On solo, don't pay the attention to the other piece of music from Gundam Unicorn. I really love the music from Gundam Unicorn. I need to pick up the soundtrack. Yep. I appreciate the fact that Leiji Matsumoto's work that like Leiji Matsumoto makes it clear that yeah, like, he likes planes, he likes fighter jets, he likes cool hardware, but he hates Nazis. So like the Yamato is the Yamato, and it's the ship of the Japanese Navy during the Second World War. It's modeled after that design. But it's also very much clearly modeled on the idea of... Oh, yeah, I could take you out with a... I'm not going to. But it's also clear that he's not endorsing necessarily the Imperial Japanese government, that he appreciates new constitution in the post-World War II Japan by having the antagonists of it, the Gamillans, being absolutely completely decked out in the trappings of Nazi Germany. So yeah, that side of things as well. Mitsukata. I got a second attack, and I don't recall how to activate a second attack there. I'm gonna have to finish you, but that's okay. Everybody.
Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the show, please like and subscribe. And also consider backing my Patreon. Patreon backers get episodes up to 1 week early of this show and any future Let's Plays. Also, please consider backing my Ko-fi. Toss me a few bucks, also helps support the show, and it's not a monthly obligation or anything like that.